Hey folks, what's up? Rob here. We're going to unbox the Ironclad Dreadnought that I purchased actually a couple months ago. Just never got around to working on it. Home life, dealing with my kids and work. Well, not dealing with my kids, but you know what I mean. And work getting in the way. So we're going to open it up. I actually have not really peeked inside on this much. I just opened it up to make sure it looked like it had all its pieces, and that's pretty much it. So, let's set this down. We have our ever-so-popular water transfers on there. We have our standard, comes with the box, base, which I may or may not use, and it looks like we have two sprues. And it's funny looking at this, as I always thought the Dreadnought would be much bigger, but now looking at the pieces I'm thinking, wow. I'm told the Contemptor pattern Dreadnought is much larger than the standard Dreadnought. I'll have to check it out sometime. Since I'm not doing pre-heresy, I'll probably not ever buy one, but you never know. And of course the instructions. Which doesn't look too complicated to build. I've seen some Games Workshop models that were just horrible. Most of my vehicles, this is the first new model, well, it's not a vehicle, it's a walker, that I've purchased in a long time, or actually heavy support. This is one of my original ones. This is a Rhino that I purchased probably 15 years ago. You can see the old style guns on it. I broke it out because I wanted to do some practicing with doing highlighting. As you can see, I lined all the corners and everything with a couple shade lighter blue. And pretty much did the same thing on my Space Marine bikes, which I'm thinking didn't turn out too badly. Alrighty. So that's the unboxing. Looks like the first thing I'm going to be doing is clipping everything out. Well, I'll start with that part right there. Now to clean these up, I have, of course, your standard hobby knife. I like this type because I can, when the blade gets dull, I can snap it off. I also have a set of jeweler's files, and I don't even remember where I got these. I think a friend gave them to me. He ended up at an auction, bought a bunch of them by accident. They were in a box of some other stuff he wanted. He ended up with like 12 sets, so he just gave me one. And since I'm going to magnetize this, I'm going to have my drill. That's what I use for drilling my starter holes. And then, of course, I'll have some drill bits. Obviously, I'm going to need some stronger magnets than what I normally use, I think. There's a magnet guide on miniwargaming.com that I will take a look at. And, well, that's it for starters. My next video will be me basically just trimming this. Will be after I have cut out the first piece and cleaned it up. Oh, and for painting, I don't have a spray gun. Plan on getting one for now. Based on some recommendations of some friends, I picked up some Army Painter Ultramarine Blue. And yes, I'm aware of the procedures of using it. Make sure you don't put it on too thick. You don't want to because it'll you'll lose detail, that kind of thing. I saw a really cool video where somebody had put together the Dreadnought from the Assault on Black Reach kit, Dreadnought kit, and I will reference that down below if I can find it again. It shows you basically what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a little battle damage on this, make it look a little battle worn. I've decided I like that look. When I first started in the hobby, everybody's stuff, you know, when you finished, it had to look all neat and new, and you know, having battle damage was actually unheard of. You look at any of the models from back in the day, none of them had damage on them, battle damage on them. Well, there were probably a few, but you know, none of the ones I ever saw. So, anyway, as I said, I will cut that part out, trim it up, and I'll show you what it looks like when I'm done. Thanks. Alrighty, gang, here's the first part of that all cleaned up, ready to start putting together. I'm already kind of started trying. Some pieces didn't seem to fit right. May just be something I'm doing wrong. Namely, it looks like in the drawing, this should be here. That doesn't quite fit. Oh, I know what I'm doing wrong. And I put the other piece down somewhere, and now I can't find it. Oh, there it is. That should fit right there. Oh, I see. There's an inner... Oh, I got it, kind of. I'll have to look at a picture. Something still isn't right. But anyway, yeah, that's it all cleaned up, ready to go. Oh, I think I kind of see how it goes together. Oh, I missed a part right there. Just when you think you got everything cleaned up, there's always something you miss. A lot of my older models, I was going over them, and I thought, well, you know, I'll clean these up a little bit. You know, I was dusting them off. This stuff I'd already painted, some of it years ago. And just kept finding mold lines that I didn't get when I was cleaning up the models all those years ago. It was kind of sloppy of me, but... there we go. Alrighty, so I'm going to start assembling this, and you'll see it when it's done. Alrighty, gang. It's also assembled. I had a little bit of trouble with the side pieces because I couldn't quite figure out where they went, and then I realized they fit inside, not at this edge right here. Fits inside nicely, went together like bread and butter in like maybe 5 minutes. So, it's all there. This is glued together. I haven't put this on because I'm actually going to paint this separately, or prime these separately. These as well. These are going to get a black primer. This is going to have the bolt gun metal trim. The wings will be gold, and the cross surrounding the skull will be... probably bolt gun metal as well, and then I'll do the skull with I have some skull white, or not skull white, but old ivory or something like that that I'll use for that, so that'll be a little different. I may also do some custom work on this a little bit once this is dry. I'm going to take my pin drill and drill out these stack holes a little bit. They're a little deeper. I've not had much luck with making these look right if they're not done that way. So that's it so far. I'm going to let this sit and dry overnight. This is going to get base coated in the Army Painter Ultramarine Blue. However, I am going to probably use some tape or something and mask off the sides, and then base coat this in black so that when it's all put together like so on the box, Let's make a non-reflective shot of that. It'll give it a bit of depth. And then I'll do some highlighting on it as well. Some, I believe I have some mithril silver kicking around. Make it look pretty good. So that's it so far. And I will pick this up tomorrow. All right, gang, I'm back. It's the next day. You can see here I have base coated my the torso part of the Ironclad Dreadnought. You'll notice I did that in blue, but I did this and the grenade launcher in black, mostly because I wanted to get more depth on these. I'll be touching up areas of this in black as well. Oh crap, just when you think you're done. Okay, well, apparently I forgot something, so... wow, how many times have I done that? Yeah, you know, actually maybe that part won't actually be seen anyway. Anyway... So I'm going to set this aside for now, and I'm going to start assembling the legs. Legs are the best part, tastes like chicken. So I'm going to start cutting those parts out, and when I get them cut out, I'll be back. Alright. Sorry about that. I had to mute a movie I was watching while I was doing this. Okay, so we have here the leg piece. The, well, I guess you'd call them shin guard for lack of a better term. And the feet. And I was just trying to figure out how I was going to set this on the base. And I think I got her all figured out. So, this is dearly... This is dry. Sorry, I'm really on at you. It was a long day. This is nearly dry, or it is dry, so I'm going to start shading in the spots where I want some depth, which is up here, in this area, in here, underneath, and I'll probably just do the underneath of this. Since I started looking at the way that this went together. Once it's together, you want to actually see this, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. And up in here. Maybe I will. Anyway. That's what I've done so far. This is all cut out after I'm done shading this. Actually, what I'll do now is I'll go prime this now. And I'm going to do this black like I did the smokestacks portion of this. And then hand paint any of the blue bits myself. With the exception of these, which I will paint blue with my can of Army Painter Ultramarine Blue. So, when I'm done with that, I'll